call unto me, and I will answer you, and show you great and mighty things which you know not.
Pray often. Prayer is a shield to the soul, a sacrifice to God, and a scourge for Satan.
If weak in prayer, we are weak everywhere.
We have to pray with our eyes on God, not on the difficulties.
In prayer, it is better to have a heart without words than words without a heart.
The greatest tragedy of life is not unanswered prayer, but unoffered prayer.
Prayer requires more of the heart than the tongue.
Every great movement of God can be traced to an healing figure.
Pray and let God work.
What the church needs today is not more machinery or better, not new organizations or more and novel methods, but men whom the Holy Ghost can use. Men of prayer, men mighty in prayer. The Holy Ghost does not flow through methods, but through men. He does not come on machinery, but on men. He does not anoint plans, but men. Men of prayer.
Prayer moves the armor that moves the world.
Groanings which cannot be uttered are often prayers which cannot be refused.
The one concern of the devil is to keep Christians from praying. He fears nothing from prayerless studies, prayerless work, and prayerless religion. He laughs at our toil, mocks at our wisdom, but he trembles when we pray.
Men may spurn our appeals, reject our message, oppose our arguments, despise our persons, but they are helpless against our prayers.
God looks not at the elegancy of your prayers to see how neat they are, nor yet at the geometry of your prayers to see how long they are, nor yet at the arithmetic of your prayers to see how many they are, nor yet at the music of your prayers, nor yet at the sweetness of your voice, nor yet at the logic of your prayers, but at the sincerity of your prayers, how hearty they are.
I shall see no hope until the individual members of the church are praying for revival, perhaps meeting in one another's homes, meeting in groups amongst friends, meeting together in churches, meeting anywhere you like, and praying with urgency and concentration for a shedding forth of the power of God. There is no hope until we do.
Ask and it shall be given you. Seek and you shall find. Knock and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asks receives, and he that seeks finds, and to him that knocks it shall be opened.